Hello, everybody, and welcome to our session on scaling managed Kubernetes clusters using Nodepool. I am Horacio González, and I work at Developer Relations at OVS Cloud. And with me, I have Kevin George, Engineering Manager of the Managed Kubernetes, and Maxime Hurtel, Product Manager of the Managed Kubernetes. So, what are we talking about? Well, Kubernetes has no native cluster auto-scaling feature. It means that you can scale your pods around your nodes, but if you need a new node, it isn't easy. We have recently released a new feature in our managed Kubernetes node pool, and they are going to help us to have a real auto-scaling in your Kubernetes cluster. We are going to do a demo using a custom dashboard for Kubernetes with a twist, Kubernetes Invaders. I will show you later how you can install and use your Kubernetes Invaders in your own cluster. So let's begin. Kevin, can you talk us about scaling Kubernetes?
Yeah, sure. So the main objective of auto-scaling in Kubernetes clusters is to scale our applications according to the load, because the load in Kubernetes clusters depends of what actually your users do. So, for example, if you pass in a TV show, we will see a huge amount of load coming. So you have to scale your application to handle this load. So basically, Kubernetes auto-scaling ensures that we always have the right amount of resources used by your apps, and so that we only pay for what we need and not for what we should unload at the max. Good news is that in Kubernetes, we already have auto-scaling features. So the auto-scaling features are working on deployment level, and so you can choose the right amount of resources that your app needs. And if your app is requesting much resources because of the load, Kubernetes will automatically add new pods to your workload. But what happens when we reach the capacity of the clusters? The autoscaler will continue to spawn new pods to handle the load, but the scheduler will fail to schedule them because our cluster is full. So we need to add new nodes in this case, and that's why we create node auto-scaling. Node auto-scaling ensures that we always have enough capacity for workloads. And managed Kubernetes launch, we provide an API to simplify the add or removing of nodes. It was a great fit for the first use cases, but after 1 year in productions, and by running workloads which require auto-scaling features, we missed a way to add or remove nodes directly from the Kubernetes API. Manipulating nodes from the Kubernetes APIs simplify advanced features like auto-scaling. That's why we introduced NetPools. And I will, Maxime, introduce you NetPools.
Indeed, this summer we released for all our managed Kubernetes customers a new feature called NetPools that allows the user to actually scale his cluster. Of course, using the control panel, but also in many other ways. Let's see at first what it looks like within the web control panel. So directly on any given cluster, you just click the node pool tabs, and then you click add a new node pool, and you will be invited to choose a given instance type, what we call a flavor, after naming the node pool, of course. And specify an initial number of nodes within a node pool. So a node pool is really a pool of nodes with the exact same flavor. You can choose to launch it early or monthly. And while this node pool is created, it's interesting to see that we can also scale the existing node pools. And scaling a node pool is just a matter of a few clicks. You open the node pool and you click add or delete a given number of nodes. So in a single call, you can add multiple nodes, for example. This is one way of doing it, but as Kevin mentioned earlier, What is really new with the node pool feature is the ability to edit that directly through your usual Kubernetes tools, such as kubectl. To do that, you just have to manipulate a new CRD, custom resource definition, that Kevin deployed within your cluster. This CRD is called node pool, and you can directly edit its parameter, and for example, the desired node, desired value from the actual CRD. And once you do that, we've got a controller that will look after it and add the nodes or delete the nodes accordingly to your needs. This feature is one of the latest that we released, and we just introduced two new improvements, allowing you to create monthly node pools, so the ability to have monthly billing with a good discount, and also the ability to have node pools with anti-affinity, which means that the different nodes from a given node pools will be launched on different physical machines, improving your total availability for your containers. Now, Horacio, let's come back to our main subject and see how we can leverage this feature to autoscale our cluster.
Thank you, Maxime. So, why are node pools interesting when trying to do cluster autoscaling? Well, the idea is with node pools, you are going to define the lower and upper bound of your node pool. For example, here you have a min number of 2 nodes and a max number of 10 nodes at any time in your pool. But you can directly say how many nodes do you want to have at any given moment with the desired node parameter. So, if you have a new pod to deploy and you have enough place in your current nodes, you can increase the desired nodes in order to expand a new node in your node pool. And you do that by talking with the node pool via the API. Of course, we will have an official node pool autoscaler in OVS Cloud Managed Kubernetes. But even at the moment where we will have that official autoscaler, it can be interesting for you to be able to deploy your own autoscaler. Why? Because there are many criteria you can choose in order to do your autoscale. You can do a very conservative autoscaler where you are only going to add a new node if your cluster is full. But then, at the moment or your cluster is full and you try to add a new pod, you will spawn the new node and you will have to wait that your node is ready before deploying your pod. So you can also try to be proactive. For example, when my cluster is 80% full, either in CPU or memory, I can add a new node to be sure that it's always available. Or you will be able also to do some cost-cutting measures. For example, if your cluster CPU and memory are under 50%, you can delay one node in order to reduce your bill at the end of the month. So, having node pools, your own autoscaler allows you to fine-tune the behavior of your cluster when scaling up and down. And then I am going to show you how have we done it. I am going to show you with one demo, Kubernetes Invaders. So here you have the UI of Kubernetes Invaders. It's a small Kubernetes dashboard, a fun Kubernetes dashboard. The idea is here you have all the node pools in your cluster. I have only one, this node pool. And for each node pool, it's going to show you the number of nodes currently deployed, the global load of your Kubernetes cluster. We will talk about that later. And for each one of the nodes, it will show you the different pods deployed. We have, in this example, 3 kinds of pods. The orange one are the system Kubernetes pods or other pods not linked to our demo, like this Velero pod in order to do backup of the cluster. The green pods are prime number generators. They are CPU pods. It's only a small Node.js program that calculates prime numbers. So it is CPU bound, and each one is going to need some 150 milli CPU. And then we have another memory graveyard pods. It's a similar pod, but writing all the result in a big array. So it's going to need lots of memory, 1 giga for each instance. So we can use this UI to add new instance. For example, I am going to add a new memory graver. I click, it's going to schedule it. Yeah. And it is going to deploy it. And the global load of my cluster is going to go up. Okay. We can add yet another. I have done an autoscaler that monitors the CPU and memory load. And when one of them is over 80%, it is going to spawn a new node. So, okay, 76%. We need yet another. Then you can see that all new instances are deployed around each one in a node. And a last one. And then I hope, yeah, we are over 80%. So the autoscaler detects that we are overbound and is going to spawn a new node. Spawning a new node can take several minutes, but we are doing it proactively. We can still deploy other pods in our cluster. So the idea is to be always able to deploy new pods when you need it. How it is done? What? Well, let me share it for you. So here you have the console out of the autoscaler. The autoscaler, it checks the CPU memory consumption every few seconds for all the cluster and for each one of the individual nodes. And in my case, if the CPU is over 80% or the memory over 80%, it's going to spawn a new node and you have the autoscaling in progress. How have we done that? Yeah, but let me show it. So here you have my autoscaler. It's a small Node.js program that do the monitoring of the cluster, but also it serves the information for the K80s invaders. As you can see, at the beginning, it's only an Express application, but the interesting part is how are we getting the information on our Kubernetes clusters? Well, we are only using sample HTTP calls. We are calling to the nodes API in order to get information about the nodes. We are calling to the pods API to get all the running pods, namespaces, nodes. We are going to call the node pool. And then here is when we need to increase the node pool. We call the API. We get the current capacity. And then we call again the API, but in the modification endpoint, in order to increase the size of our node. Same thing for the decreasing. We get the current one, and then we patch with the new size. And the real intelligence of the autoscaler, and as you will see, it's not really intelligent, but you can add more intelligent if you need, is here. So I am going to get the global load in CPU and in memory in percentage. Here I am using the requests. When you deploy pods in Kubernetes, you are declaring two kinds of resources it needs. You are declaring the requests. It means the minimum resources your pod need to work. It's fully declarative. You can declare as high or as low as you want. But if you declare something way lower than you need, Kubernetes is only going to guarantee what you have declared. In the other side, if you declare a very high value, for Kubernetes, it will be more complicated to schedule your pod because it will need to have lots of free memory or CPU space in your cluster. There is also another kind of resources. The limits is the upper bound. It's the limit of how many CPU, how much CPU or how much memory your process are going to use. I am using requests because the Kubernetes scheduler use the requests in order to be able to place a pod in one node or another. So I'm trying to be as close as possible to the normal scheduler behavior. So as you can see, I calculate the global one, and then I calculate the CPU and memory for each node. And for the auto-scaling, well, if the memory is over 80% or the CPU is over 80% or all the nodes are fairly loaded, then I am going to increase the node pool. And then if the memory is under 50% and the CPU under 50%, so I have lots of free memory and CPU in my cluster, and the cluster is bigger than 3, I am going to decrease. Why I am adding this if the cluster is at least 4 nodes? Because we don't recommend you to go under 3 nodes for your node pool, because the scheduling process, because the upgrading process, when the nodes are automatically upgraded to the next minor version. So your cluster will behave better if you have at least 3 nodes. And this is my auto-scaling. I monitor every few seconds the load, and then I increase or decrease the node in the node pool using sample API calls as decrease, increase. So we go back to our UI, and we have the 4 nodes. And the load of the 4 nodes. If we load it more, it's going to span a fifth one. If we decrease under 50%, well, it's going to liberate one node, and we will go back to 3. It's going to take some time. So, as you can see, our global load is fairly low. I am going to unload one more pod, and I hope we will go under 50%. Not yet. Okay. Yeah. And then our autoscaler see that we are under capacity. And it has eliminated one of the nodes. You still see there, because then the node is physically still in your cluster, but it isn't ready. And all the pods in that node are going to be rescheduled in other nodes. And here you have your node only with your cluster only with 3 nodes. So in this demo, you have seen how you can use node pools in order to do auto-scaling of your managed Kubernetes clusters. You can easily create your own auto-scaler, a very simple generic one like the one I have shown you in the demo, or you can create a very complex one using lots of business logic in order to be able to adapt to the kind of use you are doing with your OVHcloud managed Kubernetes. With the node pools and the auto-scaling, we are giving even more flexibility and usefulness to our managed Kubernetes service. So, as we like to say, we are change makers. We are every time listening to our customers, getting their feedback, and trying to improve our products and make them as easy to use and as powerful as possible. And of course, if you have any question or if you only want to chat with us, now it's the moment. Thank you very much.